So this is a salt of the earth guy. He talks a big talk. He backs it up, but he is a decent person. They swing right away. Now, Noah said he wanted to go right from the opening bell to take advantage, and now a guillotine attempt.
Huge mistake, Max.
Yes. Most of the submissions for Boaz Benes have been rear naked choke, but you don't know what he has been learning, and he is cranking that hard.
He is cranking it very hard. Noah seems okay. Trying to put that arm to open up. But Perez, the stronger one of the two, I would say.
Yeah.
Yes, and so athletic, and dexterity also on his side softens up Roa, maybe to go right back in with another guillotine attempt. As Rodolfo pointed out, 5-0, all those victories in Combate Global. Most recently, May of 2021, when he beat Brian Del Rosario, first round rear naked choke.
Now, he talked about training here in South Florida and training with the wrestlers. You could see that wrestling here very improved a lot from the first time, the last time we saw him here, using it towards his advantage. He's opening him up,
yeah,
softening him, ready to just clobber in that submission.
Trying to get that can over on the other end. This is his third fight of the year. He fought in April, May, and now here in September, dropping some elbows, the old Spanish archer.
And you know, he can do that. Number one, he's young. And number two, he tends to finish off his fights very quickly.
One of the Battle of Perez is back against Jair Perez back in September 2019. Roa has already gone through the grinder, finally able to see his opponent after he's had his face towards the mat. Exciting young fighters. Combate Global has a lot of them.
Absolutely. And now Roa, also a professor of physical education when he's not competing. Or training, for that matter.
Big suplex to the ground, back to the mat for Roa.
Flip to the ground work here on Perez, which he's known for. Could anticipate perhaps what we had there. Cornering him up. Look for those elbows. Look for maybe some hammer fists, some punches to soften him up. He's already covering himself, Max.
Yeah.
So Roa does seem to be in trouble
there. You mentioned from Ensenada, he runs a smoke shop down there.
That's right. Studying nutrition. That's in great shape.
I've been a chance
at
for
a cross face.
Thought about it. Roa pretty good defensively. Just got to make sure he doesn't absorb too much pressure. But the hooks are getting in underneath.
There it is, Max.
This is his bread and butter, the rear naked choke, looking to set up Roa, and Roa knows it.
Might not be a good trip to Colombia for Roa.
No, sir. After the Choco Castillo fight, when the distances may go a lot shorter, he's got to hang on. He's got about 2 minutes to kill off here.
Look at your position.
Attempt.
He was landing in those punches to be obnoxious. Nobody up there. It is.
It's getting deeper. No, he's pulled up. Cross face
again.
Back underneath the chin.
And there it is. Almost. Nope. Did you still have his chin down? He doesn't have it fully in yet.
And there's a tap. Is it? Thinking about
there
it is.
Once he makes it also easy.
His fourth victory in six via rear naked choke. His fourth straight finish in the first round. This guy's the goods.
He makes it look easy, Max.
Wow. Tell your friends you saw
Christian.
Oh, Campbell's gonna love that. He wears Combate as a shield. He is proud to be here. It's the company that got him his start, and it is the company that's putting a rocket ship on his back. Convincing win. What else is new? We'll be back for the official decision.